First, should we go to first explaining how the question came up whether Tulsi Devi is mother, and should the Gurudev explain that she cannot be mother?
First was Tulsi. In the room, there were so many.
If is mother, then she cannot enter into Ras Leela. This Jalakar Prabhu referred to Tulsi
Devi. Her general know her. But those who want to serve Radha Krishna conjugal, or if they are thinking, oh, they will never enter.
Then Shri Gurudev asked the question.
You are understanding what he is telling?
No.
Eh? Those who are not, those who are understanding, they should like do. Those who are understanding.
Those who are not understanding should.
Then all are.
All are understanding.
What Manjari you understood? What?
What did
he understand?
What he told?
That Srimati Tulsi Devi should not. We should not think of her as mother because it's against the conjugal mood.
For general devotees, oh, she may be called mother. But those who want to enter in Vrindavan, in the service of Radha Krishna conjugal, if they are thinking or they are unqualified there, they should. But then?
Then Shri Gurudev asked the question why Krishna sent back the wife of the Brahmins who came to offer, to bring an offering. Why he sent them back. And Srila Gurudev explained that to uphold karma, religious principles, and he explained also that Krishna wanted to give them his mercy, but in the next life they could get that mercy. And
what was the reason? Why what Krishna told?
Yeah, because they were also mothers.
And Brahminis, small children. Brahminis, wives of Brahmins.
Wives of Brahmins.
Can you explain more? Try to remove all kinds of doubt.
So,
as I told, you can see it now.
Unlike the gopis, the wives of the Brahminas, they were. Because they were wives of Brahmanas that upheld Dharma, and they were sent back. And also,
anyone who are Brahmins, Kshatriya, or anything, Shudra, anyone cannot enter in Krishna pastime. Only gopis. And only the gopis
who do not have children.
Yes. What is the harm if children?
Bad example?
No example for this.
No, he said it will be a bad example for others.
No.
Ananya Bhakti is not present.
Devotion is diffused.
Ananya Bhakti maybe. No harm.
Diversion.
They have some attachment for the children and some.
The gopis of Vrindavan who had children and married. They wanted to go in Ras and very, very much attracted to Krishna. But they were unqualified because they have children. And any of the gopis who were taking part in Ras, anyone has no children. If fire separation will come, and they will be burned, their mood will be burned. Then, with the help of gopis, Nitya Siddha, they can. But if they have children, they cannot go. If they are Brahmins and other caste, they cannot go. Gopis, in the guidance of Lalita Vishakha, by the mercy of Yoga Maya they can go. Otherwise, no. And what after that? Oh, yo, writer.
Ah.
And what more?
Okay. What more was on the wall?
I'm looking. I
want to see it.
Give the mic.
Oh my God! Well, you
should understand. What more I told you?
Well, first of all,
so Guru, that they can understand.
First of all, Gurudev, you told me not to chant loudly.
No, I don't. But when you are in collective.
Well, then you asked why Bhishma Pitamaha, why he was fighting against Krishna.
And Arjun.
And he was Mahajan.
And why, if he was fighting against Krishna and Arjun, is he Mahajan?
You are understanding the question?
Yes.
Why is Mahajan fighting against the Lord Krishna?
Yes.
And the answer is, because he understood the desire of the Lord to kill the demons.
To establish
Yuga Dharma. And if Bhishma, help me out here.
Didn't fight on the
if Bhishma didn't fight on the Kaurava side, then Duryodhana, I didn't have that in the notes, then Duryodhana never would have begun that war. So
why?
Because he knew he could not win without the power of Bhishma, because he was the great Maharata.
Wow.
So, therefore, Bhishma had to remain silent during the insulting of Draupadi. He had to remain silent during the cheating of Sakuni, because he knew that the plan of Krishna was to embark on the fratricidal Kurukshetra war, which would kill all the demons and all the Kshatriyas. But if Bhishma didn't support Duryodhana, then Duryodhana never would have had the courage to begin that war. Therefore, understanding the desire of his worshipful Ishtadev, Lord Krishna, he remained silent and he pretended to fight against Krishna, but he never had any intention of killing the Pandavas or Krishna.
But Maharaj also said that at the beginning of the battle, had Arjun not offered his arrow in respect to Bhishma, and Bhishma in turn granted him victory, then the battle would have been lost on from Krishna's side.
Very good.
Another point also, that Duryodhana always told Bhishma that, oh, you are fighting on behalf of me, but always you are favoring to Arjun. Then Bhishma told, oh, from tomorrow I shall kill 10,000 soldiers. But he never promised that I shall kill any Pandavas.
And also you said the glory of allowing Draupadi to be derobed to show how Krishna will always protect.
All are hearing what he is telling?
Yeah.
What he told you? What he told? More louder. Why Bhishma silent when Duryodhan and Dushasan were taking his cloth?
So that everyone could see Krishna's mercy to give to Draupadi and give her sari. So everyone could see Krishna's mercy to her. And to glorify Draupadi for
her devotion.
To prove that Krishna will always protect his devotees.
Once Duryodhana became very worried. Bhisham Pitamah is not really fighting against Pandavas. He is cheating me. And he went and told Bhisham Pitamah, why you are cheating me? I know that you don't want to defeat Pandavas. Oh, you should not think like this. You should not think like this. And then, one thing, if you have no belief on me, then you can believe by this way. Tonight, when I will be in trance of Krishna, Godhead, you should bring your wife.
Bhanumati.
Name was Bhanumati. And at that time she would come to me and I will give a benediction, boon, that anyone cannot kill your husband. So you will be Saubhagyavati.
So auspicious, fortunate.
Not fortunate. Saubhagyavati means?
Never widowed.
Or never widowed. And thus you will win the battle. Oh, he became very happy. And next night he became to ready. But in the night, so heavy rain, and so much cold, so much wind.
Storm.
He told to his wife, oh, I wanted to go to Bhisham Pitama today in night, but oh, so much heavy rain, how we can go? So we will go tomorrow, no harm. And then he was stopped and his wife was also stopped. But Krishna, in heavy rain, he told, oh, Pyari Shakhi, Draupadi, come along me. We will go to Bhisham Pitama. He has promised to give a boon to his Duryodhan wife. You should make a well like this.
Cover your face.
Covering your face. And we should go in this way. It may be that Bhisham Pitama will waiting for the wife of Duryodhan Bhanumati to give boon. So we should not miss this opportunity. Oh, come. And he took that chariot. And with umbrella, he took Draupadi in chariot. And there he went. Still, there was so heavy rain. Anyhow, he took again umbrella and sent Draupadi inside the room of Bhisham Pitama. He was in trance. She was waiting. But bell was there. Oh, folding and sitting like in a prayer mood. On knees. Bhisham Pitama, after some time, he opened his eyes and saw that, oh, Bhanumati has come. Oh, Bhanumati, Saubhagyavati Bhava. Akhanda Saubhagyavati Bhava means never we become widow. You will be victorious and your husband should be victorious. Then Draupadi began to smile and he took his veil and did pranam to Bhisham Pitama. Oh, Bhisham Pitama, oh, very wondered.
Wonderful.
Yes, wondered.
Oh, how you came? Oh, have you come alone? She smiled, no answer. Oh, tricky person. The black person has come.
Where is he?
Oh, where is he? Oh, he's just standing and waiting outside. Oh, call him. And then Krishna also entered. And then he was also smiling. Then Bhisham Pitama told, oh, your mercy to Pandavas is unparalleled. Anyone cannot defeat Pandavas. And Draupadi will be for always Akhanda Saubhagyavati. Where you are and Dhanurdhar Parat, and where his chariot, and where is a lady, chest lady like Draupadi, anyone cannot defeat them. Be victorious. So Bhisham Pitama was a high class of devotee. But only thing, he was Jnani Bhakta. Jnani Bhakta, you know? Krishna has no appetite. He never tires.
Tired.
No appetite, nothing. Any kind of arrow cannot touch him because he is transcendental. And arrow is not transcendental. he cannot touch. So he used to shoot arrow. Like Gyani Bhakta, like Sukhdev Goswami, Sanak Sanatan in his before life, past life.
First.
Sukhdev like past life. They have nothing to serve. Bhisham Pitama. He never served like this, but he helped to fulfill the ways of Krishna. But he has some desire, it has been told. One thing. Cheto darpana marjanam bhavamaha davagni nirvapanam sheya kairava chandrika vitaranam vidyabhadu jivanam anandam budhi varadhanam pratipadam purunamritasvadhanam sarvatma sampanam param vijayate shri krishna sankirtanam. What is the meaning? What you want? What? Question? Quickly.
In the Navadvipa Baba Taranga, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he meets Bhishma Dev.
In the Navadvipa Baba Taranga,
Bhaktivinoda
Thakur, Bhaktivinoda Thakur meets Bhishma Dev.
Yes.
So my question is, how did Bhishma Dev attain to Navadvipa? How he
All the associates of Krishna, whether Aishwarya or Madhurya, or the devotees of Ram, Nrisimha, Kalki, Vaman, all were assembled there. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Narayan, Krishna, Ram, Nrisimha, Kalki, Vaman, all were there. So to serve their
worshipable
in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all were there. So Bhisham Pitamaha also was there. He is the devotee of Dwarkadhish. So he was also. Understand? Anything more?
In the evening class.
If you are always asking, then you cannot hear more. Never. So try to listen more.
You can ask.
After you can ask.
The Cheto Danpar Marjan. Oh, you should. Meaning only. Where is?
Shamrani.
She doesn't feel good.
He is in trance?
No. She working and not sleeping.
And what was your question?
My question. Why sometimes Guru take this demon's disciples?
What?
Why Guru, in the morning walk, you explained how Ekalabhya, he was like a demon.
Yes, and Guru, not like demon. Demon. More than demon.
So then you said that the Guru knows the mood, the desire motivation of the disciple, the motivation. And
if he is a high class of realized Guru and qualified Guru, then he will know. Otherwise, Kaljugi Guru will not know. Those who are deviated, they don't chant, have no attraction for Krishna and Harikatha, and they are not realized, they cannot know. But if a Guru like this, they can.
So Ramesh Prabhu is asking, why a Guru accepts demons as disciples?
Anyhow to help them, that if in his life one time he has chanted even something good, see, he may give chance, and sometimes rejects. By reject, how? By heart, not outwardly. Then, you should.
In the first verse of Shikshastakam, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Cheto darpana marjanam, that the heart is like a mirror and it is covered by dust, and the chanting of Sri Krishna Sankirtan cleanses the dust from the mirror of the heart.
No, never. How? Param vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtana. Oh, param. Param means transcendental. If anyone chanting transcendental word, Shabda Brahma, in a process, then these seven fruits will come, otherwise never. So Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. How? In a process, he will be in a situation of very good devotee. Hearing and hearing, he will know our worshipable deity is Krishna. He is supreme personality of Godhead. He has so much opulences, but very merciful. And a desire to serve Krishna will come in his heart. Then he will search any powerful guru. Powerful guru. And by the help of devotee Sraman Guru, he may choose his guru. And then he will serve, asking so many humble questions in humble way. And then he will fix that, I should make him guru. And then he takes initiation in real sense. And then he follows the instructions of Gurudev and serves as a friend. By chanting these names, Cheto Darpar, with a relation with Krishna, then Cheto Darpar Marjanam Bhavati, otherwise not. This is the process. A transcendental name can come in our time. And then, really, our chitta darpan will be clean. Otherwise not. More? Cheto darpan. That is why our cheto darpan marjanam is not going. Very little, little, little. And again some dust comes. What dust?
Material.
Sense gratification comes. Try to hear. And then question.
So, if a devotee takes to the process of Sankirtan in the association of pure devotees, chanting with Sambandha Gyan, and
yes,
giving up all aparad and all anartha, then Cheto Darpana Marjana.
This Sambandha Gyan, not high class of Gyan, ordinary Sambandha Gyan, Krishna is our
whatsoever deity.
We are eternal servant of Krishna. This. What is the meaning of Cheto Darpana Marjana? You.
One will firmly be established in the concept that we are not this body and we are spirit souls, and thus he will, with this discrimination, clear the illusion between the body and mind and things related accordingly, and he will try to act on the platform that he is sold.
More?
So then gradually...
Can you?
The marjana means cleansing, darpa is the mirror, and cheta is the consciousness, the fine mirror between our srupsiddhi and our conditioned self.
What is the dust by which it is covered?
Identification in the material body, the material designation, mind, body.
Oh, so many requirements, worldly requirements, position, unwanted things are there, attachment to worldly things, so much attached to ladies, and so many things, that is kuti, nati, and all other things, they will be removed, but not totally, not totally. Something will be there. But he can see his heart, and sometimes Krishna also. In what way? Only by moods, not really. But he will realize something. And when it is chetomardhan going on, then a desire to serve Krishna and a taste in name and hearing katha may come. These are the symptoms. Then you can think that. Like, you have a library. There are so many almirahs. The
what? Doors of the almirah.
Doors of the cupboard. Or with glass.
Cupboard.
And lock is there. Books are there. Oh, the life of Prabhupada. Oh, Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. All are written there. But can you touch?
No.
Why?
The glass is there.
So, you can realize something there. But even the doors of
the cupboard.
Cupboard are there. Mahatattva is there. Very fine covering is there. Okay. Even so many anarths. No good thick relation. No taste so much. But it is coming. So this is Chetomardharpanamarcha. Bhav Mahadavagni Nirvapanam. Bhav Mahadavagni.
Because the conditioned soul identifies with his body, then he's subjected to so many different types of fear and suffering. But when he understands, I am the eternal servant of Krishna, because now his heart is becoming clear by the influence of the transcendental chanting of Harinam, then all sufferings, all sorrows, all anxiety and all fear quickly goes away. This is called Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam. That the suffering of this material world, which is like a blazing forest fire, it becomes extinguished by the influence of the chanting of the holy names.
Anyone can more explain? More? You?
In the association of high-class advanced devotees, we become aware what is really bhakti, pure bhakti. This is the
Bhav Mahadavagni Nirvapanam.
Then, by practicing this pure bhakti, automatically all our problems, all our difficulties will go away. And so many wonderful, auspicious opportunities we see everywhere to render service.
Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam means, Bhava means to taking birth and again going to death. So we are coming in this world for timing unlimited, we are taking birth and going to death again and again by cyclic order. So by the influence of chanting transcendental Harinam, this Bhava means to coming and going from this earth, coming and going to death, it will be stopped. This is Mahabhavat, this is Bhava Dabagni, it will be stopped. So this is also one point of this.
More?
And
more points?
Coming in this world, we are suffering in threefold miseries. Abdhatmik, Adidoivik, Adibhautik. So all living entities, especially human beings, they are suffering all these miseries being in this world. So if we chant holy name, by influence of chanting pure holy name, then it will be also stopped.
Oh, a very strong dog was going on the road. And he has something in his mouth. And so many dogs were following. And they were trying to take and to attack that dog. Oh, so many, 20 or more than 20 dogs. Oh, in the meantime, his master came at once with a
stick.
Danda, a stick. And all the dogs
ran away.
And now he is very bold and barking towards them. Oh, come on, come on. Oh, for this example, you should see that so many unwanted things, anartha, aparad, were with that devotee. But he, Cheto Marjanam, came and he offered his whole life, whole senses and everything, and became Saranagata.
Became surrendered.
And if he surrendered, then who will protect him and save him?
Whom he surrendered.
Then if he surrendered and Krishna is there, then all kinds of Bhaumaha Davagni
will go away.
Means all the suffering, sorrows, problems, the pain of birth and death, all will go. Bhava means to take birth and to die. And to always burning in threefolded misery. This is Bhava Mahadavagni. When you are
surrendered.
And Krishna has
accepted.
And now you are chanting somewhat, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Krishna is not different with them. He will come at once. And he is so powerful. So all threefold miseries and Bhava Mahadagni will at once go away if you are in process. And with strong faith like this. Sreya Kairava Chandrika Vitarana. You know? You? Sreya Kairava Chandrika Vitarana.
Is that where the moon of auspiciousness comes and gives us nourishment?
Rays of the benediction.
Getting mercy? Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam. The moon of auspiciousness. The example is given of the lotus. By the influence of the moon, starting to bloom.
Krishna Bhajan. Always with me and hearing.
This spreads the white lotus of good fortune to all the living entities.
Again.
Spreads the white lotus of good fortune to all living entities.
What is the meaning? Lotus will come.
The misconception of the body as the self.
It has gone in first Cheto Darpan Marjanam. If anyone living with me, they should know all. You, Jagmohan? Try to sit.
The rays of the benediction moon, being the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that before the time of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there were not such high conceptions.
Give. If you cannot, give.
Shaya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam. Here.
Very important things. If you are chanting name in this process, the seven fruits will come and you will realize and taste. And if not, then even Shraddha has not come. You are fallen and it will, by symptoms, you will more fall. And you will be very weak and very far away from this.
The third wonderful result which is attained by chanting Hare Krishna, after the cleansing of the heart and the extinguishing of the forest fire of material existence, is that Shuddha Sattva, Bhava Bhakti, makes its appearance within the heart of the sadhak, and thus his life becomes auspicious because his transcendental identity becomes awakened. This is called Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam. Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma Prema Suryangsu Samyabhak Ruchibir Chitamasrinya Kridaso Bhava Uchate. When the essence of Sambit Shakti, the knowledge potency, and Ladini Shakti, the pleasure potency.
What is Kairo? What is Chandrika?
Chandrika means the Harinam. And by the influence of Harinam, Shuddha Sattva, which is the rays of the.
What is the meaning of Kairo?
Kairava. Kairava means the lotus.
Lotus.
Chandrika
is the moon.
So name is Chandrika, Chandra himself. Moon. Moon has rays. In moon rays, also much nectar.
Wow. Nourishment.
Nourishment, nectar. And by nectar, what will be?
Lotus.
Oh, by these rays, oh, all the lotus will be in
bosom.
Blossom. And madhu will be in
honey.
And then black
bee.
Who is black bee?
Krishna.
So devotee is like
lotus.
And name is like Chandra. If he is chanting in this way, Mahadavagni has gone away. And in the guidance of high class of pure Rasik Tattva Vaishnava or Guru, he is chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Oh, this name will give his kiran,
rays.
And in rays, what is there?
Nectar.
Honey, nectar is there. What nectar? Oh, Krishna prema, bhav. And it will come. And all the devotees will be in bosom. What is the meaning? All kind of auspicious things will come in him. First, all kind of klesh will go. Klesh means?
Miseries.
Miseries will go. And all kinds of virtues or good qualities will come. He will be humble. Trina dapi suni, tarorapi sahisununa, amanina, manada. He will be tolerant. And so many qualities. And he will have taste. So these will come. By the mercy of, oh name, Krishna. Then, fourth,
Vidya
Badhu Jeevanam. Oh, time is now over. We will, next day we will explain very well. And you should try to know all these things. And then chant, oh, your name will be high class, first class. And you realize, oh, Cheto Darpan Marjanam, Bhav Maha Dhavagni, Sriya Kairava Chandrika. Oh, then no question of deviation. Nothing. Always he will
progress.
Gaur Prema.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare.